I was asked in the Museum of Jewish Diaspora in Tel Aviv, one sees that you wear in the theater, one looks at your museum. And I said, no, what you're seeing is not that I was in the theater. What you're seeing is that I didn't come from another museum.
Weinberg od razu na początku narzucił swoją wizję. Chodziło o to, że to ma być muzeum narracyjne. I to właściwie zdeterminowało wszystkie prace dalsze nad tworzeniem muzeum, nad tworzeniem wystawy.
W 1998 roku wizja zaczęła się urzeczywistniać. Pierwszym pomysłem było stworzenie bazy judaiku.
Z Instytutu rozesłaliśmy zapytania do około 600 muzeów w Polsce. Otrzymaliśmy pozytywne odpowiedzi chyba od 1/4.
Trzeba było zwerbować ludzi do współpracy, którzy by pojechali do Przemyśla, Sanoka, Wałbrzycha, Poznania, Koszalina.
Do tych około 150 muzeów jeździliśmy. Wszędzie tam byliśmy.
Zadaliśmy sobie pytanie, o czym ma być ta wystawa? Kto ma być jej bohaterem? Jakie mają być ramy czasowe, terytorialne, geograficzne naszej opowieści? Co to znaczy w ogóle być polskim Żydem i dlaczego ta opowieść będzie o polskich Żydach?
We got a call one day from Jerzy Halberstadt, who was the then director of the museum project, and he said, I want to come and see you. I found the museum that I love most in the world, and you did it, and I want to know how you would treat our museum.
It's a really nice pattern.
It's a really interesting question, how it's possible that it would be an English company making a museum of the history of Polish Jews. I think when I consider the process by which we make any museum, it's always the same principles.
I mean, it's called the street, but we very much had Nalewki Street.
Yeah. We've done museums in Russia, we've done museums in most cities in Europe, we've done things in America. They all have different sensibilities. They all have different priorities. What our job is to find out what those priorities are.
My role on the job was to really work with the academics and the curators to develop the content and to develop an understanding of what they want to say through the content, and then to work with the designers on the team to translate that into a three-dimensional experience.
So no matter how many times you put something into it, he couldn't respond because he hadn't in his own head worked out.
My role within EVENT over the years has been master planning. Master planning of the narrative is taking all the different strands of that narrative and laying them down basically on paper.
Praca z projektantami, którzy postawili sprawę zupełnie z innego punktu widzenia, czyli że pokazujemy historię, a nie ją opowiadamy, było ogromnym doświadczeniem. Naprawdę musieliśmy przemyśleć raz jeszcze nasze podejście do historii.
One of the key principles of the interpretation is to tell the story through primary sources, so the personal stories of Jews across the centuries.
All that really matters is that the people of today walk into it and meet the people of the past and understand what the priorities of those people was.
W tym pierwszym etapie podział ról wyglądał mniej więcej tak, że historycy pisali coś, co było dość bliskie podręcznika historycznego. Znaczy określaliśmy główną linię narracyjną i główne zjawiska historyczne, do których się mamy odnieść, a eventi układali z tego narrację muzealną.
We listen to the stories they want to tell, and then we suggest to them how they can be best interpreted and best made relevant in a museum context.
Niektóre z tych dziwnych pytań, jakie zadawali nam eventi, to były pytania o kolor, albo z jakimi emocjami kojarzy mi się XIX wiek, albo z jakimi zapachami kojarzę hasydyzm.
It was fascinating to hear them discussing it. You learn so much when people, you hear people arguing or rejecting someone's ideas, because you really start to understand where the priorities are. So it was a very engaging and very enjoyable period in the project, sitting with those guys, eating with those guys, drinking with those guys, and developing the story.
In 2002, Michael Steinlauf, an historian in Philadelphia, who was working very closely with Jerzy Halberstadt, he said to Jerzy, he said, you should talk to Barbara. And I met with him and I thought, this is really, really interesting. I was skeptical about a multimedia narrative exhibition because the last thing in the world that I wanted to see was the history of Polish Jews as Disneyland. We wanted something that would be really state of the art. And therefore, once I understood we could take inspiration from contemporary performance, installation art, and environmental theater, and that we could do something that was really artistic and very substantial and thoughtful and even critical, then I got very interested.